Hello. Tonight, I want to share with you the treasures of the bourgeoisie. First, a sip from the white wine. Pinot Grigio. I have here some boxes with buttons and some more buttons. But this little box, I arranged things in it, and unfortunately the camera doesn't work well. If I tilt it much farther, everything will fall out. These little things were in the button box, but they're really like double hooped buttons, kind of. And this little piece of costume glass was, look how it sparkles, just like a glass diamond. It was in the button box. This was in another box. This is a picture of my grandmother's big brother. Let's have a little more light here. My grandmother's big brother, he's over here. This is him. You see, you can see he's a boy. Already they've had their hair different. Just a few years old and they had their hair different. Yes. That's my grandmother's big brother and big sister. My grandmother was the baby in the family. She was the fourth or the fifth. Let's see. Three sisters and one brother. My grandmother was the fifth child that lived. In those days, children sometimes died. In fact, about half of them did. It was different than now. And this is a hand-painted button that one of somebody in that family did, I think. And this is a belt buckle, I think from a lady's belt, because it's so delicate. And it's just shiny brass. Nothing's, look, you can see it's already rusting a little bit 100 years later. And this is a little toothpick container. You could put a toothpick in there. And my brother made fun of me when I sniffed it. He says, "Oh, he's smelling it. He doesn't even know what's in it." "It's for cocaine," he said. It's very, very 1800s, very 19th century. I think it was either my great-grandfather's or someone, some guy in that group. And I put this together in this little box. It's a little puzzle box of things about my grandmother's family from Kansas. It's really nothing very valuable. The picture is emotionally valuable. And the buttons, I leave it open because I'm not done yet with it yet, but that's one of the secrets of the bourgeoisie. And then there's another. Where is it? It's over. Oh, darn it. Where did I put it? Here it is. Over here. This is a thing that you rest your fork on the table. You rest your fork there so that the dirty tines of the fork don't touch the tablecloth. They rest on this piece of glass. And the thing that's fascinating is it's so interestingly carved. And if you turn it on end, everything starts to look like it's three-dimensional inside this mysterious, magical world of glass. Look at the leaves almost seem to rise up out of the glass. And it's just carved with leaves and flowers. But when you look at it, it has depth. Very beautiful and amazing. Ooh. Yes, you see? There's my eyeball. As well, I have to be careful with those things because they chip easily. It's glass, you know. These are a tea glass would be set in this like this, except of course it's not a wine glass. It's like a regular glass like this round. Set it in here, then you have your glass of tea inside the metal holder. These are from the Soviet Union. In fact, there's a little stamp here that says made in USSR. You see that? Look, there I am. And then there's something written in Cyrillic letters, which I can't read. I think I've got it upside down. Yes, you see that? Those are Russian letters. The one in the middle looks like OI, but that's one letter joined together. I don't know if you can see, but the OI is actually joined together. It looks like an M, but that's not what it's called. I'm afraid I forgot the name. I don't know all the Cyrillic letters. I know a few, but not all, the whole alphabet. There's four of those. Different colors and patterns. Very pretty. And, oh, here's one of the really pretty ones. There are four of these. The other one's holding another. This is also for supporting your fork at the table. But this one is from my stepfather's family. There, this is the one I wanted to show because it has all cute little penguins on it. And that's why I put this fork holder in that one because it's so beautiful. 7 minutes and 52 seconds. Jeez. If I get this done right, I'll cut it at 10 minutes. Now, that's enough of the bright light. I've shown you the things. Those are some of the treasures of the bourgeoisie. Those little cups, those four metal cups from the Soviet Union. My stepfather bought those before he married my mother, back when it was just him and his wife at home. She was kind of sickly. She died about 4 years before my mom and him got together again. They were friends when they were younger. What was I saying? Oh, the metal cups. He went on a trip to the Soviet Union with his oldest child, my stepsister, and their uncle and a cousin. And four of them went to the Soviet Union, and it was it 1967 or 19? Yeah, I think it was 1967. And those metal tea holding glasses have been up in one of the cupboards up above, up there, ever since those cupboards were built after my mom moved in 40 years ago. And now they're down. We've emptied all those cupboards up there. They're all empty. And we've washed and, well, I've done the washing, but we've given away a lot of urns for flowers that are just simple glass things. Nothing special, not like these. And, I have one other treasure of the bourgeoisie that I have to show you. This lovely horse. You see how the horse is bending down and biting his foot or licking his foot, one or the other. Beautiful little Chinese horse, made very simply, just plaster. But somebody made this with a little bit of grace, and it's very charming. And my mother's niece rode a horse when she was younger, and she used to compete as a girl and as a teenager before she grew up. And she had two horses that I remember, and the youngest one she had until after she was married. It lived until she was almost 30. But she had a horse when she was a young girl and in her teens, and then about 16 or 17, she got another horse. I don't remember what happened to the first horse. I don't remember whether it died or what. It was a long time ago. But I do remember she always loved her to have a horse and to ride in the riding parades with people and competing with how well you can ride your horse. And she used to go up on trips to different parts of California with her father, my uncle. He'd drive with her and they'd tow the horse trailer behind them. And I thought, when I saw that little horse, I thought I should give that to my niece, my cousin, to my cousin, my mom's niece. Yeah. Well, those are my little bits of treasure. I have one more thing to show you. This is real beauty. This is a beauty. This is a jam pot. You see, it even has a little hole in the lid where you can put the jam spoon down into the jam in the pot. And look how the glass has been etched with a lovely design of kind of flowers and grapes. And very fruitful sort of images. And we're going to have to decide between the five of us who gets to have the jam pot. Yeah. I heard the little ding-dong a minute ago, which means I got a message. So I'll take a look at that while I'm finishing out my last few minutes of this video log. Oh. Yes, that's good. Nice answer. Well, my friends, I'm going to end this at 14 minutes instead of 15. So I will say goodbye. God bless you. And thank you for listening to my Treasures of the Bourgeoisie.